So we're going to kind of end this section talking about something called blocking highs. So of course, high pressures we call anticyclones. And what a blocking high is basically it's a surface anticyclone at the surface that does not get the hint that it's necessarily supposed to move on here in the feral cell, in the mid-latitude westerlies. So it persists, and the problem with something, any sort of pattern staying around for too long, is whatever weather is associated with that pattern, you're going to get for a long time. And when I'm talking about a long time, I'm talking about 2 to 4 weeks worth of whatever weather is there. Now, in general, what a high pressure is basically it's at the surface anyway. It's diverging air, and so we have descending air from aloft. And actually, high pressures tend to be warm and dry. But what they can do is, if they're stalling out downwind from them, or I should say down kind of current from them, the folks that are used to kind of getting a cycle of highs and lows and highs and lows, anticyclone, cyclone, anticyclone, cyclone, they don't get any relief. So this stagnant weather you can either have drought or you can have flood, okay? It's just not good having too much of a good thing. Okay, so anticyclones, stalled anticyclone. And one of the things that results from a stalled anticyclone or anticyclones can bring down, you see here, bringing down actually Arctic air or continental Arctic air, very cold air from the north. And so a stalled anticyclone in the wintertime can bring us not necessarily blizzard conditions, but a very clear conditions, but very, very cold. And then to kind of leave you on this note, that actually a blocking high can bring floods elsewhere where the high is not. And in 1993 and 2008, I would think that if you were around in this neck of the woods, you remember those as extreme floods and or a lot of water. And the reason for the flooding those 2 years was from blocking highs, or from a blocking high. Just the weather was not moving like it should. And so here are some. This is rainfall for a 2 week period, June 08. And here's an aerial view of Cedar Rapids in 08. And then for 1993, this photo goes back to 1993. And this is just kind of showing the counties in Iowa and Illinois and Wisconsin and Missouri and Minnesota that got hit hard with rainfall that year, again from a blocking high.